Chapter 8, Safety, Health and Welfare of Workforce. Worker health, safety and well-being is of utmost importance to the conscientious employer. Verified units analyze and strive to prevent all potential adverse effects on the health or working conditions of workers and have an action plan in place to reduce and prevent the risk of accidents in the workplace. Workers have all the tools, training and facilities to carry out their jobs in the safest way possible. Explanation. This chapter covers necessary points related to prevention of adverse effects on health of the workers caused by their working conditions and has an action plan in place to reduce or prevent the risk. Health and safety at workplace is about reducing risks and protecting people from harm, injury or ill health arising out of work activities by ensuring the right controls. The duty of an employer is to manage health and safety issues in his business by providing safe working conditions and creating awareness among the employees. Code Requirement 8.1, a mandatory criteria point. A policy statement of the organization is in place on the safety, health and welfare of the workers in line with the national legislation. The intention. A policy on health, safety and welfare demonstrate the management's commitment and intention to provide a safe, clean and healthy working environment to the employees in line with all the relevant laws and national regulations. What you should do to meet the code requirement. 1. The estate, factory and smallholder group is to adopt a health, safety and welfare policy. 2. The policy is to include a statement of commitment towards health, safety and welfare. The policy statement needs to cover all employees, permanent, temporary and casual. The policy needs to cover issues such as A. Significant hazard risks relevant to the organization. B. Commitment to meet all OHS legal requirements. And C. Commitment for improvement of safety performance. 4. The policy is to be documented and implemented. 5. The policy is to be communicated and made available to interested parties, all employees, permanent and contractual, suppliers, customers. Communication can be through displays, websites and awareness programs. 6. The policy is to be reviewed at least annually. Records and documents. Policy statement. Check reference materials for the model trustee policy. Code Requirement 8.2, a mandatory criteria point. There should be documented risk assessment and action plans identifying all potential hazards and risks to workers' health or safety. The intent. Risk assessment is the process to identify what in the operation could cause harm to people and take adequate measures and precautions in advance to prevent them. It is a process of evaluating the risks arising from hazards, taking into account the adequacy of the existing controls and deciding whether or not the risks are acceptable. Hazards is the source, situation or act with a potential for harm in terms of human injury or ill health or a combination of these, and risk is a combination of the likelihood of occurrence of a hazardous event and the severity of injury or ill health that can be caused by the event. Controls are measures taken to prevent them. The process to meet the code requirement. 1. The estate and factory is to conduct a risk assessment at least annually. 2. Follow these steps for doing risk assessment. A. Identify the process and related activities within the process. For example, CTC machine operation is a process and related activities are starting the machine, loading of leaves, cleaning, maintenance, etc. B. Identify the hazards, physical, chemical and biological. Hazards also include mechanical, electrical, pneumatic, hydro, chemical, social as well as behavioral and those under emergency conditions. Defining of controls can follow the typical hierarchy: elimination, substitution, engineering controls, administrative controls and finally for the residual risk, use of PPEs. C. Decide who may be harmed and how. D. Evaluate the risks based on severity and probability. E. Decide on precautions. F. Identify gaps in the existing system and implement the controls. G. Review the risk assessment and update if necessary. 3. For health and safety risk assessment, consider the following. A. Machinery. B. Use of hand tools and sharp implements. C. Working at a height, for example ladders. D. Lifting and moving heavy and awkward objects. E. Workshops, for example where machinery is repaired or on-farm engineering takes place. F. Handling, storage, application and disposal of chemicals and agrochemicals. G. Electrical safety, including power lines. H. Fire possibilities, emergency situations. I. Fuel stores. And J. Medical issues. 4. An action plan is to be developed on the measures to be taken, for example, guarding machines, training on health and safety, putting up signages, etc. 5. Document the risk assessment and action plan. Records and documents. Risk register containing the risk assessment done. Action plan. Training record on risk assessment, if applicable. Check for sample formats and reference material. Code requirement 8.3. A mandatory criteria point. The verified facility shall provide a safe working environment with respect to building safety and air quality, noise and lighting levels are all within safe parameters. Measures are also in place to ensure machinery safety, fire safety and electrical safety. The intent? It is the factory management's responsibility to ensure that a safe and healthy working environment exists for all workers and that all risks to health and safety are minimized to the largest extent possible. Poor air quality, high noise levels, and insufficient lighting can result in long-term health problems, including respiratory ailments, hearing loss, and loss of sight. It is essential that precautionary measures are in place to prevent accidents and that appropriate equipment and procedures are available in the unfortunate event that an accident does occur. This is what you do to meet the code requirement. 1. Make sure you comply with the Factory Safety Act 20. 2. Also comply with the Electrical Act and rules. 3. Monitor air quality, noise and lighting levels regularly to ensure they are within safe limits. If unsafe limits are detected, an action plan must be drawn up and implemented. 4. Boilers, furnaces and forklifts should be regularly maintained and have valid permits and inspection certificates. 5. All moving machinery parts should have guards in place that provide a barrier to both body parts and loose clothing. 6. Post notices prominently on risks associated with machinery. 7. All machines should have emergency stop buttons that are clearly visible and be easily accessed. 8. Mark floors clearly to delineate production areas. 9. Ensure that all wiring and circuitry are properly housed. 10. Maintain and inspect electrical systems regularly. Fire safety. There should be sufficient fire exits from each room enclosed area, including factory buildings and processing packing areas. At least 2 fire exits must be available from each room enclosed area. However, practical aspects should be considered if the area is open or has large windows that are easily accessible. Fire exits must be free of blockages and unlocked at all times. The exits should open from inside easily without the need for a key. Fire exits to be clearly marked and pictorial signs in the language familiar to workers. Employees should be able to hear the fire alarm from every corner of the factory and be familiar with the sound. An evacuation or fire exit floor plan should be developed showing the fire escape routes and exits and displayed where it is clearly visible to workers. Fire drills should be carried out regularly and assembly points clearly marked to ensure all employees know the procedure for escape. The assembly points, however, should not pose any obstruction in firefighting activities, access to fire engines, use of hose pipes, ambulance movement, etc. The responsibility of informing the local authorities in case of a fire gone out of control must be assigned to someone. A group of people are to be trained in first aid and firefighting. there should be sufficient fire extinguishers and other firefighting equipment to handle different types of fire. For example, general fire, electrical fire, chemical fire, etc. The equipment should be inspected and serviced at least once a year. Fire extinguishers must be positioned at the correct height and along escape routes. Have emergency lighting, enabling workers to find the fire exits in case of electrical failure. Smoking should be prohibited in work buildings and near any flammable material storage. Records and documents, electrical inspection certificates, list of firefighting equipment, fire refilling certificate, evacuation plan, and record of fire drill. Code requirement 8.4, a mandatory criteria point. There shall be documented training in place for all workers engaged in various jobs as appropriate to the task and as per the risk assessment. The intent: a good risk assessment reveals possible hazards in different activities. Workers associated with the activity must know about the related hazard and ways to minimize the effect. This enables them to perform their tasks safely. Apart from the formal training to make people competent, a well-structured introduction to the actual work, on-the-job training, including familiarization with the main procedures, time to practice what they have learnt, and suitable assessment is also needed. Process to meet the code requirement. 1. The estate and factory must identify the training needs as per the risk assessment for all the workers, and a training plan is to be made. 2. The training plan to include will also train, whom to train, topics to be covered, methodology to be followed, and when the training is to be conducted. 3. All employees, managers and supervisors are to be trained in health and safety hazards and how to manage them. 4. Specific training for all work in hazardous areas are to include A. Safe operation and maintenance of machinery. B. Chemical application. C. Handling of chemicals. D. Storage of chemicals. E. Transportation of agrochemicals. F. Disposal of chemicals. G. Working at heights. H. Confined spaces. I. PPE usage. J. Emergency procedure. K. Any job-specific legal requirements, for example, first aid. 5. Training in health and safety has to be appropriate to the tasks performed by the workers and be conducted by a qualified person. 6. Health and safety training is to be a part of the induction process for all new workers. 7. Training on health and safety is to be provided free of charge in the workers' native language and during working hours. Refresher training for existing workers must also be conducted. 8. Evaluation of the effectiveness of the training will be measured. The same is applicable for all of the training imparted to the people, including STG. Records and documents. Training plan in line with risk assessment outcome. Code requirement 8.5. This too is a mandatory criteria point. The verified facility shall have at least one person trained in first aid available to group members, workers at a central location where production, processing or maintenance activities are carried out. The intention is, providing first aid is a specialized skill and the first aider training must be conducted by an authorized person or agency. Enough people need to be trained in first aid. In case of emergency, the availability of a trained first aider is very critical to provide immediate medical attention. What you should do to meet the code requirement. 1. Ensure that a person trained in first aid is always on duty in the workplace. 2. Training should be conducted by qualified organizations or persons that are available, such as A. Medical officer, B. The Red Cross, C. The local doctor or hospital, and D. St. John's Ambulance. 3. Train plantation supervisors in basic first aid. 4. Provide first aid equipment which should be readily accessible to the personnel authorized in the factory. 5. Familiarize workers with the trained first aid person and how he or she can be reached. 6. Post a notice listing the names of persons qualified in first aid treatment with worksite details near each first aid box. 7. display a list of contact details at prominent places in the factory that can be approached at any time in case of emergency medical situations. Records and documents, first aid training record, list of the first aiders, list of emergency contact numbers. Code requirement 8.6, a mandatory criteria point. Fuel stores, petrol, diesel, gas, kerosene, coal, fire, wood, shall be stored in such a way that there are no risks from fire and flood or contamination of the area. The fire safety provisions shall be undertaken and documented in accordance with the Factory Act 1948. The intention is, most farms need to store fuel for use in vehicles or pumps. The purpose of the requirement is to ensure effective storage of fuel to minimize the hazards from fires, etc. Spill and overfill protections are important as they can prevent a number of small releases over a long period of time from polluting the groundwater. Fire safety provisions helps prevent and manage fire. Process to meet the code requirement. 1. Fuel storage. A. Construct fuel stores with non-combustible material like bricks, galvanized sheets, etc. B. Fuel stores should be away from the farm and watercourses. They should be downslope of a well at reasonable distance, a minimum of 30 meters away from it. C. Fuel should always be in containers designed specifically to store fuel, for example, jerry cans. Never store fuel at the following places: under staircases, in living room accommodation, fertilizer or CPP stores, or with other inflammable material, for example, hay, straw, or grain, or close to an emergency evacuation route. D. Fuel is to be stored separately from agrochemicals. E. Fuel storage tanks to have spill and overfill protection. F. Prevent fuel backflow by installing check valves in pumps and not in the tank. G. Inspect tanks, pipes, and equipment regularly for damage and corrosion. Carry out maintenance and repaint metal tanks on the outside to prevent corrosion. Inspect bunds and keep them in good condition. H. A drip tray with sand or other absorbent material can be used as a short-term measure to collect the drip. I. Avoid overfilling vehicle tanks. J. The contents of stores need to be labeled. K. Store workers are to be trained on the safe use and handling of flammable substances. Records and documents, fuel store record, material safety data sheet, MSDS. Code requirement 8.7, a mandatory criteria point. A register shall be maintained documenting all the accidents reported in the garden and or factory. The register shall also maintain reports on action taken by the management and compensation given as per law. The intention is to take effective measures on accident prevention, identification of all the accidents and the causes behind them to be done. Action against each accident needs to be taken to ensure non-recurrence. What you do to meet the code requirement. 1. Report and record all accidents and near misses. 2. Record the cause, impact and response to accidents in writing. 3. If the lost time injury is more than 48 hours, report accidents to the inspector of factories. The estate, factory and smallholder should compensate workers in case of injury or accident in the workplace in line with the Workmen Compensation Act and relevant state act. 4. The estate should have an accident and emergency procedure which is clearly communicated to its workers. 5. Accident investigation is required to route through a risk analysis process and need to route the identified corrective action through a risk assessment process. Records and documents. Incident, accident register, risk analysis report of the occurrence. Code requirement 8.8, a mandatory criteria point. Personnel protection equipments, PPEs, and clothing shall be provided free of cost to all workers on hazardous jobs. Must be suited to the type of work, product, as per the MSDS, or machinery, as per the instruction manual, handled, and the PPE should be used properly by the workers. The intent is, making the workplace safe includes providing instructions, procedures, training, and supervision to encourage people to work safely and responsibly. Even where engineering controls and safe systems to work have been applied, some hazards might remain. Where the health and safety risk assessment indicates that personal protective equipment, PPE, is required, as an initiative to control the risk, PPE needs to be provided appropriate to the type of the job, product, as per the MSDS, or machinery, as per the instruction manual handled. Process to meet the code requirement. 1. Provide workers with PPE suited to the type of work, machine operation, spraying, mixing chemicals, generator operation, MSDS, and instructions manual for the machines. 2. PPE is to be provided free of cost to all the workers. 3. The PPE should be appropriate to nature of work being performed. 4. Train workers in the correct use of PPE and on detection and reporting of faults. 5. Make wearing PPE mandatory, even for those jobs that only take a few minutes. 6. Check with the supplier for job-specific appropriate PPE. If in doubt, check with a specialist. 7. PPE for pluckers should be footwear, gloves, umbrella, and apron. 8. For sprayers, gloves, mask, boots, goggles, and spraying suit. 9. For mixers, it would include gloves and boots. 10. Provide air muffs for those working in high noise areas. 11. PPE must be properly looked after and stored safely when not in use, for example, in a dry, clean cupboard. If it is reusable, it must be cleaned and kept in good condition. 12. Check regularly that PPE is used. If it isn't, find out why not. 13. Safety signs must be put up to remind people that PPE must be worn. 14. Records of issuing PPE needs to be maintained. 15. Repair and maintenance of PPE is a must. Records and documents, PPE issue register, record of training on usage of PPE. Code requirement 8.9, a zero tolerance criteria point. Adolescent workers who have completed their 14th year but have not completed the 18th year, and women shall not be involved in handling and spraying of agrochemicals and any hazardous processes. The intent is to ensure that adolescent workers, pregnant women, and nursing mothers are not exposed to hazards arising out of handling of hazardous chemicals and also spraying of agrochemicals. Process to meet the code requirement. 1. A list of hazardous chemicals needs to be identified. 2. There should always be an age verification process to ensure the age of any young worker and that they are engaged in work acceptable for their age, not just with regard to using hazardous chemicals. 3. Women, nursing mothers, and pregnant women must not be deployed for work involving handling of hazardous chemicals and spraying. Records and documents, list of hazardous processes, list of persons deployed for the hazardous processes. Code requirement 8.10. The verified facility should provide safe and hygienic washing facilities and free access to adequate clean toilet facilities for all workers. The intention, the estate shall ensure the well-being of workers by providing them with safe and hygienic washing and toilet facilities. Process to meet the code requirement. 1. Provide washing facilities. In case hard water is used for washing facilities, there should be clear indication of the water being non-potable. 2. The washing facilities should be kept safe, hygienic, and should be cleaned regularly. 3. If practical and necessary, provide drying facilities for wet work clothes. 4. Provide for sufficient number of latrines and urinals of the prescribed types that are conveniently situated and accessible to workers at all times while they are at the plantation. 5. Toilets too should be kept safe, hygienic, and should be cleaned regularly. 6. The number of toilets should be appropriate for the number of workers present. Toilets should be separate for men and women. Code requirement 8.11. The verified facility should provide free access to clean and safe, portable as per national or local legislation, whichever is higher, drinking water for all workers. The intention being, the estate, factory, and smallholder groups shall provide effective arrangement for free access to clean and safe drinking water for all the workers employed. the process to meet the code requirement. 1. Access to drinking water should not be restricted and be available in all areas of the workplace. 2. All such points must be clearly marked, drinking water, in a language understood by workers in the factory. They should not be situated within 6 meters of any washing place, urinal, latrine, spittoon, open drain carrying sludge, effluent or other source of contamination, unless otherwise approved by the inspection authorities. 3. Provide potable drinking water. 4. Drinking water should be tested annually to ensure it is potable and record should be kept. 5. Testing to be done by accredited laboratories. Records and documents. Water test report as per IS 10500. Code requirement 8.12. Medical facilities including first aid boxes for workers and their families as prescribed by the local law should be provided at work facilities. The intent: to ensure that workers and their families are provided with adequate medical facilities. Process to meet the code requirement. 1. Every plantation factory should maintain its own dispensary or first aid post. 2. Medication, including over-the-counter medicines like aspirin, nausea pills, indigestion tablets, cough, cold tablets, etc., must not be issued, administered to workers by any employee or kept in any first aid kit unless A. prescribed and administered by a licensed physician or other licensed healthcare provider authorized under local regulations to prescribe and administer medications. They are required by local regulations to be maintained and available. 3. First aid box or cupboards must be clearly marked with a red cross on white background and follow the equipments as specified in factory's rules specified to each state. 4. The kit should be protected from dust and moisture. The kit should contain simple and clear instructions on first aid and be in the charge of a responsible person qualified to render first aid. 6. The kit must be regularly inspected and kept fully stocked. 7. In hazardous environments, the first aid kit must have eye wash arrangements such as wash bottle or a way to direct clean water from a tap to the eyes. Frequency of changing the water in the eye wash bottles has to be daily to ensure there are minimal microbial growth, development of slimy layer on the inner side of the bottle. The nozzle of the water bottle needs to be protected against deposition of any dust or foreign particulate matter. 8. The ambulance room, wherever applicable as per law, should be under the charge of at least one whole-time qualified medical practitioner, assisted by at least one qualified nurse or dresser cum compounder and one nursing attendant in each shift. 9. The estate and factory should provide facilities to the workers and their families in accessing the dispensary and hospital as prescribed by local law. 10. The number of doctors, nurses and health attendants employed in the dispensary and hospital should be as per local law. 11. Workers including sprayers and workers employed for hazardous work, medical tests need to be conducted as per Plantation Labour Act 1951 and Factories Act 1948. Records and documents, list of the items to be kept in first aid boxes, records of medical consultation.